Hello all, this is Vishal from PEM team. Today I am going to show you the demo on how to configure pgBouncer in PEM. This video will provide a detailed information about using pgBouncer as a connection puller for limiting the number of connections from PEM agent toward the PEM server on non-Windows machine only. For this, we need to perform three different steps at database server level, at pgBouncer level, and configure the PEM agent. So let's start with the detail. Before starting the demo, I would like to show you how this works, how pgBouncer works with PEM. Basically, each PEM agent connects to PEM database server using SSL certificates for each individual user. For example, an agent ID with 1 connects to PEM database server using the agent 1 user. Similarly, agent ID 2 connects to the PEM database server using agent ID 2. Prior to PEM version 7.5, there were few limitations that did not allow to use connection puller between PEM agent and PEM server. Those were, the PEM agent uses SSL certificates to connect PEM database server. Second is, it uses an individual user identifier when connecting to PEM database server. Now, from 7.5 onwards, we have modified the PEM agent to allow the agent to use common database server instead of dedicated PEM user, agent user, to connect with PEM database server. We recommend using pgBouncer version greater than or equal to 1.9 as connection puller, as it supports SSL authentication. PEM agents can connect to pgBouncer using SSL certificates. So now we will prepare the PEM database server to work with pgBouncer. The following example demonstrates the steps required to configure the PEM server. So for that, we will create one dedicated user called pgBouncer on PEM database server. So let's log into the PSQL terminal. After logging to PSQL terminal on PEM database, we will create one dedicated user called pgBouncer on PEM database. Also, we will create another user called PEMAdmin1, which would be the non-super user with PEMAdmin and PEMAgent pool role membership. Also, we will create role permission to PEMAdmin1 user. After that, we will grant PEMAdmin and PEMAgent pool role membership. Also, we will grant connect privilege to pgBouncer user on PEM database. Follow this, we will grant usage privilege to schema PEM. Followed by this, we will grant execute privilege to pgBouncer user on function pem.getAgentPoolAuth. Now we will use pem.createProxyAgentUser1 function to create username pemAgentUser1 on PEM database server. this function will allow pgBouncer user to use proxy user on behalf of agent. After that, we will add below entry in pghb file. This will allow pgBouncer user to connect with PEM database using MD5 authentication method. After saving this, restart the database service. So this completes setting up the PEM server. Now we will move to second step, that is configuring the pgBouncer. In our example, we will run pgBouncer as Enterprise DB system user. The following steps outlines the process of configuring the pgBouncer. In our case, you can see I have installed EDB pgBouncer version 1.9 from EDB yum repo. After this, we will change the owner of etc directory of pgBouncer where pgBouncer.ini resides to Enterprise DB system user. Also, we will change the permissions to 700. Now, we will make the EDB pgBouncer 1.9.ini file blank and replace the content as per our document. You can refer third steps in configuring the pgBouncer. Make sure you use the correct port for PEM server. Also, the listen port should be correct for pgBouncer and make sure the certificate path is correct. Now, we will use the below psql command to create and update the authentication file for pgBouncer. So for that, log into psql. Use the command mentioned in step number 4 as it is. Make sure you give the correct password for pgBouncer and PEM admin 1 user. Execute this command on psql terminal. Note that a super user cannot invoke the PEM authentication query function pem.getProxyAuth. Hence, if the PEM admin user is super user, you must add the password to authentication file. After this, we will create a HVA file for pgBouncer. I am inserting the content as mentioned in step number 5 for configuring the pgBouncer. We are using MD5 as authentication method. After this, we will change the owner of this HVA file to Enterprise DB and also we will change the permissions to 600. After this, we will enable the pgBouncer service and we will start the same. So this is for configuring the pgBouncer. This completes our second step, that is configuration of pgBouncer to work with PEM server. Now we will move to third part, that is configuring the PEM agent. So now we will configure PEM agent to work with PEM server using pgBouncer. For this, we will execute one self-registration command to instruct local PEM agent to connect with PEM server using pgBouncer. For this, we will execute the command mentioned as per document. In this command line argument, the PEM-agent-user instruct agent to create new SSL certificates and key pair for database user PEM agent user 1 in root slash .pem directory. So you can see new certificates on root.pem directory. Also, this will create new entries in agent.cfg file. Here you can see new port 6432, which is configured with pgBouncer, and also you can see new agent ID 2. So on PEM UI, you would be able to see two agent entries, out of which we need to make one entry false. So for this, log into PSQL. Now you can see only one agent which is connected to PEM server using pgBouncer. After that, we will add one entry in HBA file to get the PEM admin 1 user connected with PEM database. After this, we will restart the pgBouncer service. Now we will try to log in on PSQL terminal using user PEM add agent user 1. So now we are connected to PEM database using user PEM agent 1 user 1, which is configured against pgBouncer. So this is for local agent and local server. In similar way, we can do it for remote agent as well. So now on PEM UI, you can see one agent which is still in unknown status. So for that, we need to remove the old certificates from root slash .pem directory. Before that, take the backup of those certificates. Now restart the agent service. Also on server properties, change the server properties as below. Select the new agent and give the username password. So now the new agent 1 connected to PEM server using pgBouncer. You can see agent is up and running. So this video shows how to configure pgBouncer in PEM. So we have done it for local agent. agent and local PEM server. In a similar way, you can do it for remote agent with PEM server. Thanks for watching this video.